Hey guys, so in this live video, I'm going to show you how to press a few neoprene items. The first one is going to be a seatbelt cover. As you can see, I made this for my car. I'm gonna show you a little trick on how they don't move, how I don't make them move. The one thing I am going to do is differently is when you close this one, you can see where the edges underneath the black flap didn't press. So I'm going to tuck my paper underneath there too on this next try. But overall, I'm pretty happy with how it came out. The next items I'm going to show you how to press are these neoprene pop sleeves. So hope you guys can see what these are. If you don't know what they are, they're popsicle holders. They're very popular during spring and summer for the little kiddos, like daycares and sports organizations, and so they don't freeze their little fingers. You just put this over the popsicle sleeve. Finally, the last thing I'm going to show you how to press is going to be these lunch totes. These lunch totes are really thick because of their size. They're not the average lunch tote. So what I did is I made me a jig out of cardboard. Thank you, Nell, for that idea. I've been trying to figure out how to do it. So as you can see, they're really thick right here, which gives them a little bit of a hump right here and can make them a little tricky to press. So I'm gonna press these and hope that they come out because I'm doing it live. So basically what I did is I took one of the totes, I took a piece of cardboard, I outlined it to the entire size, and I used thin cardboard. So what you can do is you got to fold it to kind of get it in there, you fold it, and then you open it up and expand it in there, and you just kind of adjust it to how you want it. Okay, I'm not going to do a full bleed on this one. I'm only going to do a baseball design. Also, if you trace the bag, I don't recommend you do Sharpie like I did, because then it can get on the edges if you're tracing it and then you waste a bag. Use a pencil. I just couldn't find one and I didn't care if I wasted one or not. So now, as you can see, I have the jig on this side ready to do this side. All right. So when you put it on the other side, there's still the other hump. So you'll have to adjust the cardboard jig on the inside so that you can press the other side. And we'll do that as we start pressing. Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to adjust the camera around. Okay. So let's do the seatbelt first. If I can find that other one. Those are the pop sleeves. Seatbelts do come individually packaged. I have a current group buy on these. If you're interested, go to our group buy group. Okay, so I cut the templates are available to download in our group buy group. So they sent me two different kinds. Over the last several orders, I didn't catch this, but they sent me two types of seatbelt covers. They do the same thing, they're just made just a tad bit different. So as you can see, this one has more of a wider area, but which means it folds more like that, okay? I think these were part of the first one and those were the revised ones. I don't remember. So I just went ahead. The templates are available for both if you get those from me. So it doesn't matter. They're still the same. They're still the same design. So what I'm going to do is, first things first, I don't know if y'all remembered in this last week's webcast, but Stan said he wished his paper would roll both ways, his lint roller. Well, there is a way to do that. And the trick is to simply bend your paper over just a tiny bit and stick it. That's all you do. Okay. And then it'll roll both ways for you. No problem. You need to lint roll anything you're going to do material wise. If you don't get all the loose fibers off, then what happens is when you press, you're going to see little blue lines. Okay. know some of you know what I'm talking about, so you don't want those little fiber blue lines on there. Now, I think this is what I was talking about trying to, and I need to cut this. So, because I want to put this in the lip of this, I'm just going to cut the excess paper so that I can tuck it in there. I'm just gonna lift it and I'm gonna tuck that paper right underneath there. And it may be hard to do because of the edges, so I might have to, it may not work unless I trim down the ends too, so I might have to do that. They made for a little bit of a bleed, but it's okay. I'm just gonna trim down each side a little bit. Since the design is not based on the edges, it's more catered to the center, this shouldn't matter at all. Okay. Looks like it's that way. Okay, there we go. Let's just see if we can kind of tuck this in here. There we go. I know this is taking a little more time. It's just because I'm trying to make this look perfect. After all, it's going in my car. What I would do now is, so it stays in that lip, I would just put some tape like right so. All right. Okay, so next what I would do is you do tape these face up, and so what you want to do is so that the paper will have a tendency to lift. I'm actually going to pull this down a little bit more, and it may not stay. Okay. There we go. Just put it like org. All right, so what you want to do, the trick is here, when you put the heat on this, it's going to cause this seat belt to kind of bubble up. And if you don't have the paper seated down really good on it, it'll cause the paper to shift, therefore causing shadow. So my trick to that, tape it down as many areas, one on each side, to the actual paper, and it won't shift on you. And I'll show you that after I press it. All right, so that should be good. So it's gonna hold it down. You're gonna put your paper on top, and then you're going to press 400 degrees, anywhere from 45 to 60 seconds. And so I'm doing it, I believe, for 50 seconds works well enough for me. So we'll just wind down the time here and come right back. Okay, so 45 seconds is, or 50 seconds is what I chose to do it for, is up. Don't forget your heat gloves. Now, I don't know if you guys can see, but can you see how it's already bubbled up? There's the paper lifted over there. So, we're gonna take this off. And you can see how it's kind of bubbly throughout there. So by taping it down to the paper, you've ensured that it'll actually stay. So next, I'm just gonna kind of push down in the center and pull up. And as you can see, it pressed with no pressure issues. You can still see that kind of a white line a little bit right there. But to me, it's not that big of a deal. Overall, it's a really, really, really nice seatbelt cover. You could use these for individuals that have medical needs, and if they were to get into an accident or something, the, you know, emergency help could know how to contact who. And my templates are designed to show you with the guidelines on how to center these. Mine may be a little bit off, but there we go. If I don't have it. There we go. So there you go. So here's the two designs of the seatbelt covers. All right. So those came out nice. And those are actually, these are actually going in my car. Next, we're going to do the popsicle sleeves. I also have a open group buy on these as well. They come in packs of 10. So here's a pack of 10. I'm just going to do these two right now. Again, you need to lint roll really good. Now the time on these are a little bit differently. I go 4:10 for 20 seconds. Okay. And you want to get all the lint, all the loose fibers off these things. All right, so next, here's my template for a football design. I'm just going to center these and then wrap it, and then I'll press each side. I want it to be that way. Making sure you guys can see. And what I do is use a little bit of spray on these, just a little bit of spritz, as Stan would say. And then I'm also going to use tape. I put the edges towards the out and just wrap it around. Okay. Then I just take a piece of tape and also close it shut just to ensure that the paper doesn't move, because these things have a tendency of bubbling a little bit. A little spritz of adhesive glue spray, sorry. And just gonna line this up as best as I can. And just put one piece of tape. You can do multiple of these at a time. Yesterday, I think I did 6 or 8 of these in the press at one time. Right now, I only have 2 left to finish on an Etsy order. So you're gonna close them. You're gonna do 20 seconds on each slide. Hey guys, these pop sleeves need very light pressure. If you put too much pressure, you'll squish them. As you can see, I had no issues pulling that down. Very light pressure. Okay, all right, we're done with this. Making sure you guys can still see everything. Okay, so now we're just gonna flip over and cook on the other side for the same time. Ready for the next item. Okay. Now I need a glove. I think on these, though, I really don't use a glove half the time. I keep one of these little razor blades handy because it helps me get the tape off. And I just kind of slice down to cut it open. And then you peel off quickly. peel off. All right, so these are the pop sleeves. Okay. You could probably benefit from making a jig from these, a cardboard jig as well, like you do socks, so that you can rotate it a little bit, so that you can get this an even bleed down the center. I have not done that yet. That'll be the next thing I attempt to try to master these. But for the most part, for these little pop sleeves, everybody loves them just as are, and I sell quite a bit of them on Etsy as well. Okay, so I'm getting ready to press this baseball design on the lunch tote. First things first, you gotta put your jig in. Gotta unzip it. And you wanna fold your cardboard jig in half. So you kinda just, okay, so the important part and the purpose of the jig is because these are such large totes that they have large bottoms to them. So you wanna make sure the jig is all the way down in on one side of the bottom of the tote. When you're ready to do the other side, you'll move the jig down to that side, okay? First things first, you've got to lint roll all of your extra, any loose fibers that could be. Could be on here. The next thing is to pre-press. So you need your protective paper. And you're going to pre-press for about 20 seconds. Which that does is it releases any moisture out. About 10 or 15 seconds will be good. It gets any moisture out and releases any, and helps flatten the neoprene just a little bit. Okay, so you see how the neoprene has bubbled really bad here? This is what tends to be the problem for most neoprene products, is that when it bubbles and expands like that, it causes the paper to shift, therefore causing shadows. Okay, so we've got to figure out a way to keep that from happening, and that's what I've been working on today. So I'm gonna give my paper a little bit of spritz. I'm gonna center it on here, okay? The next thing you do is you wanna tape down, you wanna make sure your bottom paper is taped down to your platen, so it doesn't move. You wanna take and you wanna put a little piece of tape on all four sides. Okay, just a little bit over the edge so that it does not shift. The paper doesn't pull up, okay, because it will pull up. The next thing you do is you need to take your top piece of paper. And you need to tape this down to the bottom piece of paper. This is very important so that when you lift the press, it doesn't pull up any of the paper. This is just extra precaution and what I do to make sure that this works for me. And I just put a couple pieces. On all sides, just to help reassure that it's not gonna lift, okay? And if you gotta tape it down to the actual bottom of your press, that's fine as well, okay? So now, you don't want too much pressure, because if you do, then it'll leave lines. So we're gonna go 400, and that's too much. We're gonna go 400 degrees, a little bit more, for 60 seconds. at light to medium pressure, okay? The next thing we do is when we do lift it up, when the time is done and you move your top press off, don't pull the paper off immediately. Let it cool for about a minute. I've also found that that helps too with any shadowing and causing the transfer paper to shift. So we'll come back after it's finished pressing and after I gave it about a minute to cool. Okay, so I've had time to let it cool down, so I'm going to start lifting the top piece of the paper. Alright, now we're going to do okay, so overall, I think it came out pretty good. I think we could go with a little light pressure. So I will do that on one more print. We'll do the other side. So when I say by moving the flap, you just shift the cardboard down to that side, all right? So keep in mind, if you're gonna do a full overall design, that it's probably not going to have these lines. So in order to get rid of these lines, you've got to have less pressure, or you got to make the paper bigger to hang over. So that may be what I try on the next one. So on the other side is we're going to print it on bigger paper. Yes, you're going to waste the paper, but that's probably going to be the only way to resolve that. So we'll go ahead and do that next. Okay guys, in the next tote that I'm pressing, I've already experimented with one side, and I took this picture that I took with my iPhone from my visit in New York when I went to go visit Stan at Coney Island. This is from the amusement park there. I did do some editing, but I like how it came out. Now this is for pretty much a full all over design, and I changed up. My cardboard was starting to get flimsy and it was starting to give in some areas. So if you're going to use a cardboard, use a little bit stronger piece. I know I said you need to be able to bend it, but use a little bit stronger piece, or you're just going to have to make several of these cardboard jigs. So what I decided to try out, because I was getting some because of it giving out in the center, I was getting some pressure issues, as you can see on this one right here. So it wasn't pressing all the way. So it made me think, what can I do to change that? So I remembered I have some of this foam that I got in a kit from Coastal's website. And basically I just took a piece of foam like this and I used my cardboard jig and I just cut it out to the same size as the cardboard jig. So that's what I have in here now. Now keep in mind, if you're gonna reuse this, ink's gonna get on it, so you're going to wanna just use it just for these totes. So now we're gonna do the other side, and same thing, you wanna put the foam all the way down to the flap of the bottom of the side you're gonna press. I'm gonna try something different with this. I'll show you that in a minute. So first things first, let's go ahead and do a preheat. I'm also changed my temperature. I'm gonna put this in the file instructions in the group by group. I'm gonna note that what I found works best is 360 degrees for 120 seconds. I'm gonna get a clean piece of paper. Also, if you do a dark black design like this, I recommend that you use a clean piece of paper each time, because you don't want to transfer over from the last press. Now, with the foam in it, it's going to be a lot thicker, so you'll have to adjust your pressure. So pre-press for about 20 seconds, and then we're going to put our design on. We're gonna go ahead and use the spray, the adhesive spray again. You can get that from any of your vendors. Coastal, Condi, and just Johnson's Plastics. Now again, I taped my bottom paper to my platen so it doesn't shift, and that's so that I can tape my design to there. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna spray a little bit of spritz, as Stan likes to say. And now we're just going to place it on there directly in the center. Okay. All right. Now on this, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to wrap the edges around as much as I can to help see if it'll, the trick is gonna be though, is if you put tape on, if you put tape on the black too much of it, it may leave a mark. So you gotta be careful with that. I'm just gonna try it for the sake of the video anyways. So it may not work. All right, I'm not gonna mess with it because I think I got another idea. So I'm gonna flip it over. And now remember that these things like to bubble when you press them. So the trick here is, so that your paper does not shift, is to tape your paper down, your transfer paper, to the paper on your platen. This is going to be the same with the seatbelt covers for those of you who had trouble with those as well. Okay. It just ensures that it doesn't move. Let's see, on this side, you can push the tape down. All right, so that way it won't move on you. Now we're gonna go ahead and press for the 360 medium pressure. Oops. And to get that medium pressure, I'm gonna have to do some, lift my pressure up and then so I can get my top over. Come on, behave. All right. Just making sure my paper's on there. Then I'm gonna put my pressure back down and we're gonna do 360 for 120 seconds. I think I did too much. All right, we'll be back when it's done. Okay, so we're done. I'm gonna hold my paper down so I can move my heat press off. Pull my drawer out. And I'm going to start with one corner here, and I'm just going to go ahead and tear it. And it came out pretty nice. Okay, so you can see how well it came out. A little short on the bottom, but the bottoms are wide on these, on these particular totes anyways. The only thing I would do differently now is, and I don't know if this is actually going to work, so I'm going to try it on video and we'll go from there, is, let's see if I have a different foam in here, a different size maybe. That'll make one. All right, so I'm going to use a different piece of foam here. And what I'm wanting to accomplish is getting this to turn black. So what we're gonna do is, I'm printed out, when I printed that out, I just printed a black rectangular so I could put it on here. Just gonna try to trim as close as I can to the edges so I know exactly how to place it. Now, if you're gonna try this, and I don't know if this is gonna work, so this may be a total fail right here. If you're gonna try this, I recommend that your design that you make is pretty much going to be a solid color on the edges, going to the edges like this, so this probably is not going to work. I'm hoping that it will be in just a solid color. And we're gonna trim that about right there. Okay. And you're just gonna put a couple pieces of tape to hold it down. And you wanna put the tape at the ends. This one I'm gonna tape on the inside so it'll stay. Now the tricky part is going to be to get this to press. So I'm kind of leaving the bulk of it hanging off, and then I'm gonna try to get my press to come in without burning myself. We're just gonna see how it goes. And we're gonna try to press it. So, making sure I give it enough pressure, I'm gonna go ahead and go for the 120, and then we'll come back and see how it looks. All right, so I'm cutting it short about 35 seconds because this is not that big of an area, so it should be fine. All right, let's see how it comes out. Okay, so what I was afraid of is that it would leave some extra marks on the edges, but overall not bad. So what I'm gonna do is trim it down even more for the other side. So let's just try it on this side. So basically what you're wanting is not too much black. You're going to try this, because if you put too much black, then it'll start to change colors at the ends, at the edges, I mean. Okay, so I'm going to put a piece of tape here on the inside to hold this one in. And then we're just gonna put a piece right here. Now remember, this is just for testing to see if something you guys can do. All right, so I'm gonna put my paper on it. Now, I'm not all the way to the edge here, so I need to make sure I get that way. I mean, I make sure it was too far to the edge, so I mean, it wasn't too, all right, I can't talk. I need to make sure that it's in the platen, so, and it was hanging out, so I couldn't do that. And I think that might work. All right, so we're gonna press again for about another 60 seconds. Okay, so now, I hate him. That's my son, my immature son. So on this side, I don't think it did as well as it did on the other side. So this may be something you guys don't wanna try at home, folks. Always wanted to say that. But overall, the design still looks really good. You know,
it's iffy.
And go away, son. Let's see. Let's try something. Hope that won't work. Okay, so on a black design, you could blend it in by taking a Sharpie marker if you really wanted to. I've done this on frames, never done it on a bag before, but so like on this end, we just wanted to cover some of that green up that's showing. Okay, I don't think I recommend that for home. It doesn't look too bad, but I don't know. I think I would just leave it as is. I mean, but like I said, if you're using black, you can't even, you can blend it in. There we go. Yeah, I guess you can tell. I wouldn't do that at home, everybody. So anyways, I do like how it came out, and I showed you that using the pillow, the foam inside the center of it is the best way to go. I wouldn't mess with the edges unless your paper prints, if your paper prints long or wider, then you could probably do a full wraparound on it. But this is just to show you that you can do a full coverage design. It will go just straight to the edges, and that's what it'll look like on the bottom, with a seam of white, possibly a small seam of white, if you line it up correctly in the center. All right, but overall, I mean, they pressed really nice, and I feel like the foam really does the best for it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Some instructional, like I said, we are learning just like you guys are, and we're just trying to pass along some tips. So we'll see you guys on the Stamie Show.